Carbohydrates, or sugars, are one of the major classes of biomolecules. They are an important source of energy for cells, are used for cell-cell recognition, and are used as a coating to protect cells or even entire organisms. The simplest carbohydrates are monosaccharides, which are units that can be joined together to form larger and more complex carbohydrates. In this video, I will cover the basics of monosaccharide structure and nomenclature. Monosaccharides have the general formula shown, where n is a number usually from 3 to 7. From the formula, it looks like each carbon is attached to water, which explains the name carbohydrates. We name monosaccharides according to the number of carbons they have, with the suffix OSE as shown. The triose glyceraldehyde is a simple example of a monosaccharide. As for all monosaccharides, one carbon is doubly bonded to an oxygen atom. This is known as a carbonyl group. Each other carbon is attached to a hydroxyl group, also known as an alcohol. In glyceraldehyde, the carbonyl is on the end of the carbon chain, so it is called an aldehyde group. Therefore, glyceraldehyde is referred to as an aldose. In the other triose, dihydroxyacetone, the double-bonded oxygen is attached to an internal carbon to make a ketone group. Such a monosaccharide is called a ketose. Notice that the middle carbon atom in glyceraldehyde has four different chemical groups attached to it. The aldehyde carbon on the left, the hydroxyl carbon on the right, a hydroxyl group directly attached, and a hydrogen atom. These four chemical groups will form a tetrahedral arrangement around the central carbon atom. There are two different ways that the four groups can be arranged around the central carbon in three-dimensional space. The two possible molecules are mirror images of each other and are called enantiomers. Two enantiomers have the same chemical groups, but cannot be superimposed on each other and therefore are distinct molecules. To make them exactly the same, you would have to break two of the bonds and reattach the chemical groups in the other orientation. As an analogy, consider a left and right hand. They have the same essential structure, but cannot be oriented in exactly the same way because they are mirror images of each other. Carbon atoms with four different chemical groups attached to them are called chiral carbons. Note that the other two carbons in glyceraldehyde are not chiral because they do not have four different chemical groups bonded to them. We need a way of easily representing the different possible three-dimensional configurations of glyceraldehyde and other monosaccharides. To help show how we do this, we can rotate the structures of glyceraldehyde. Imagine looking at the molecules from the perspective of the arrows. From that angle, the H and OH groups would be coming towards you from the central carbon atom, and the other groups would be pointing away. The diagrams at the bottom of the screen are intended to show that. The two horizontal bonds are supposed to be coming out of the screen at you, while the two vertical bonds are directed away from you, pointing into the screen. Instead of drawing the bonds to the central chiral carbon as triangles to try to show the three-dimensional arrangement of the atoms, it is simpler just to draw ordinary straight lines. This type of diagram is called a Fischer projection, after the pioneering carbohydrate chemist Emil Fischer. When a monosaccharide is represented in this way, it is understood that the horizontal bonds are meant to be coming out of the page or screen toward the viewer, while the vertical bonds are supposed to be going into the page or screen away from the viewer. The structure in which the hydroxyl group is on the right side in the Fischer projection is called D-glyceraldehyde, and the structure in which the hydroxyl group is on the left is called L-glyceraldehyde. Shown here are Fischer projections of some example monosaccharides. The name of each monosaccharide is shown for convenience, but we do not expect you to memorize the structures of the different monosaccharides in this course. These monosaccharides are all hexoses because they contain six carbons. They are isomers of each other because they are the same chemical formula, C6H12O6. Glucose, galactose, and mannose are aldoses, while fructose is a ketose because of the positions of the doubly bonded oxygens in each molecule. To number the carbons of a monosaccharide, we start with the carbon at the end of the molecule closest to the carbonyl group. So, for each monosaccharide shown, carbon 1 is at the top and carbon 6 is at the bottom. Notice that the three aldoses each have four chiral carbons in them, carbons 2, 3, 4, and 5. Fructose has only three chiral carbons, carbons 3, 4, and 5. The Fischer projections are intended to indicate the stereochemistry or arrangement of bonded atoms around each chiral carbon. Notice that the D form of each monosaccharide is shown. For any monosaccharide, the orientation of the highest numbered chiral carbon determines whether the sugar is D or L. For each of these monosaccharides, the hydroxyl group of the highest numbered chiral carbon is on the right in the Fischer projection, just as it was for D-glyceraldehyde. Therefore, all these monosaccharides are in the D configuration. For each monosaccharide, the L version is the mirror image of the version shown. Some organisms make L sugars, but most monosaccharides found in nature are D sugars, and from this point forward, all monosaccharides you'll see in the course will be D sugars. If you compare glucose and galactose, you will notice that the stereochemistry around each chiral carbon is the same, except around carbon 4. Monosaccharides that are isomers and differ only by the stereochemistry around one carbon are called epimers. Glucose and mannose are also epimers, differing only at carbon 2. In the next video, I will talk about how monosaccharides can cyclize to form ring structures.